हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू स्टैंडर्ड 9 सब्जेक्ट साइंस। वी आर इन द एनिमल टिश्यू सेक्शन एंड इन दैट इन द लास्ट लेक्चर वी हैव सीन द कनेक्टिव टिश्यू एंड इट्स टाइप्स। इन दिस लेक्चर वी विल अंडरस्टैंड अबाउट द मस्कुलर टिश्यू। द मस्कुलर टिश्यू ऑल रिलेटेड टू मसल्स। सो मस्कुलर टिश्यू कंसिस्ट ऑफ विच टाइप ऑफ सेल्स इट हैव? एलोंगेटेड सेल्स मीन्स इन द लेंथ दे विल हैव द कंसिडरेबल लेंथ। Also called muscle fibers also. Muscle tissue is also called muscle fibers. This tissue is responsible for movement in our body. All the movements that we do in our body, all the movements are done because of this muscular tissue. Muscles contain special proteins called contractile proteins, which contract and relax to cause movement. Why the protein, this type of protein are called contractile protein? Because they cause the contraction and relaxation of the movement. Because of this protein only we can contract, our muscles can contract and relax. So it is called contractile protein, this type of protein. We can move some muscles by conscious will. Some muscles we can move by our conscious will, means whenever we want to move it, we can move it. Muscles present in our limbs, that is the muscles in the hands and the legs, move when we want to, when we want them to do, and stop when we so decide. The muscles of limbs, that is of hands and legs, you know that when we want to move them, it moves, and we want to stop it, when we want to stop it, it stops. Such muscles call voluntary muscles because they work as we wish, as we will. These muscles are also called skeletal muscles as they are mostly attached to bones and help in body movement. These muscles are also called skeletal muscles as they are mostly attached to bones and help in the body movement. Under the microscope, these muscles show alternate light and dark bands or striations. This is the figure A we have in our textbook. Figure A, you can see dark, light, dark, light, dark, light strips we can see. And in that one cell, so many nucleus are there. So it is called multinucleated also. And this dark, light bands are there. That's why it is, as a result, they are also called striated muscles because they have bands. So striated muscles it is called. The cells of the tissue are long, as you can see it is long and cylindrical also. Cylindrical, long, cylindrical, unbranched because it is continue or one only, no branches there. So it is unbranched. So long, cylindrical, unbranched and multinucleated, having many nuclei. You can see many nuclei, 1, 2, 3, 4, like that. Many nuclei it has. So this type of muscle is called striated muscles or voluntary muscles or skeletal muscles. Three types of name it has. Now next type is this B type. In that, the movement of food in the alimentary canal or contraction and relaxation of the blood vessels are involuntary movement. This type of movements, which type of movements, which are done in the alimentary canal of the food, when the movement of the food, when we eat something, you know, it is digested and it is transporting in the alimentary canal. So it transporting by contraction and relaxation, and in the blood vessels also everything is transporting. It is without our will, that is involuntary movement, means we cannot really start them or stop them, simply wanting to do so or not. They are the function of that type of work is automatic, means autonomous, self-working. So involuntary muscles control the movements. They are also found in the iris of the eye. This type of muscles are also in the iris of the eye. And where it is? In alimentary canal. And where it is? In blood vessels, iris of the eye, in ureters and in the bronchi of the lungs. So this is its location, where it finds, where it is found. Which type of muscles they are? They are involuntary muscles. The cells are long with pointed ends. You can see the cells are long but pointed at the end. At the end you can see pointed here, here pointed, and in between the thickness is there. This type of shape, you know, it is called spindle shaped. The cells are long with pointed spindle shaped, that is. And uninucleate means having only one nucleus in one cell. It is one cell, and in that one cell one nucleus is there, so it is called uninucleated. Uninucleated cells. And they are also called unstriated muscles. Unstriated, why? Because they don't have the bands like this striated muscles. Dark and light, that type of structure it doesn't have. So it is called unstriated muscles. So this is second type of muscle, that is called involuntary or unstriated. And in first type we have seen the striated muscles or voluntary muscles or skeletal muscles. Now the third type of muscles that we have, especially in the heart, so the muscles of the heart show rhythmic contraction and relaxation throughout the life. You know that the heart is beating continuously, rhythmic beat is there, and because of the rhythmic contraction and relaxation, so they are having the special type of muscles. So muscles of the heart are which are doing the contraction and relaxation, and that is specially rhythmic contraction and relaxation throughout the life. And this is also involuntary muscles, because it is also not in our will. They will do autonomous work. So these involuntary muscles are called cardiac muscles. Cardiac muscles, like figure C is given. This is cardiac muscle cells given. Cardiac muscles, heart muscle cells, that is cardiac muscles, cylindrical. You can see they are cylindrical in shape. And branched, you can see here the branches are there, here and here the branches are there. And uninucleated means in one cell one nucleus will be. You can see the nucleus in this one cell, one nucleus, this one cell, one nucleus. So it is uninucleated also. So this way we have seen in this lecture the muscular tissue, and in that also three types of muscular tissue we have seen. That is, the first one is voluntary muscles, in that it is also called skeletal muscles or striated muscles because of this bands are there, dark and light. Second type of muscles we have seen, it is involuntary muscles, and it is unstriated muscles also called. And third type of cardiac muscles we have seen, which are found in especially in the heart only. Heart muscles are of cardiac muscles type. So this way we have to write all the types of three types of muscle tissue, and with the figure we have to explain it. And explanation must be, again I will say that it will be, the first we have to write the location of it. All the types of the muscles are there, so where they are located, that we have to write location. And the structure we have to write the second one point as, and the third point we have to write the function of each. Thank you.